Tesla's semi-real-world sighting showed that a cleaner, quieter future is possible for the trucking sector. And when I say Tesla semi-real-world sighting, I mean the Pepsi Tesla semi, which Pepsi is already using. The Tesla semi may still be in its initial production, but the units that have been delivered to PepsiCo are already making a strong statement in the world. If anything, these Tesla semis from PepsiCo emphasize the idea that it is possible to adopt a cleaner, quieter alternative to conventional trucking solutions featuring large, noisy, class 8 diesel powers similarities, actually semi-trailers today. It is easy to forget that while diesel-powered trucks have been the norm for a very long time, they do come with their own set of inconveniences. In 2021, researchers from the University of Michigan highlighted the issue of noise and air pollution caused by these heavy-duty diesel trucks running through neighborhoods in southwest Detroit. Residents in affected neighborhoods told the media that the presence of large diesel trucks is challenging because they tend to be noisy and their emissions are significant. Some residents also noted that constant sound from the diesel trucks had become a stressor for them. Actually, they are stressors for me when I hear them. Anyway, such issues are directly addressed by vehicles like the Tesla Semi. Being all electric, the Semi is arguably the quietest Class 8 truck on the road today in the world, with most of the vehicle's sound seemingly coming from its wheels. The absence of an exhaust pipe on the Tesla Semi also means that regardless of where the Semi travels, people around it would not need to worry about inhaling harmful substances. Needless to say, the Tesla Semi is a glimpse of cleaner, quieter future for the trucking sector. And thanks to the growing number of Pepsi Tesla Semi fleet, the electric vehicle community can now get a glimpse of what an electric truck-powered future could be like. And I wonder how many other companies have already ordered their Tesla Semis, just like Pepsi did. Social media posts featuring the Class 8 all-electric truck in action, I mean Pepsi Tesla Semi, showed that the Semi is indeed a very quiet vehicle, and unlike its diesel-powered counterparts, it would likely not be as much of a nuisance for residents even if it travels through inner city streets. The lack of noise and emissions from the Tesla Semi is only the tip of the iceberg for the Class 8 all-electric truck's inherent advantages. The vehicle is equipped with numerous safety features and driver-centric functions that would likely make the Tesla Semi a great truck to drive, even for drivers who have spent decades operating a conventional diesel similarities. Of course, both drivers and operators have to be open-minded enough to try out the Tesla Semi before the vehicle can truly make a difference. By the way, in one of my older reports about Tesla Semi, some of you guys asked to show a video how Tesla Semi backs to the loading area. I actually emailed Pepsi asking if they can do a video and send it to me, but I haven't heard from them so far. Now, considering the initial reception of the Tesla Semi from Pepsi and the general public so far, it appears that the enthusiasm surrounding all-electric Class 8 trucks is very substantial. This is good news overall, as noted by CEO Elon Musk during the Semi's first delivery event. After all, trucks comprise just 1% of all vehicles on the United States road, but they are responsible, look at this, for 20% of all U.S. vehicle emissions and 36% of all U.S. vehicle particulate emissions. It is then in everyone's best interest to change the status quo. So if within 10 years, let's say, or 15 years, the trucking industry's fleet will change from diesel-powered trucks to electric trucks, electric semi-trucks, we can expect a significant change in our emissions and how significantly the clean air will improve in our cities that we all breathe. Let me know your thoughts. What do you think about Tesla Semi and their growing number of users? Tesla has teased its next electric car with a new image of the silhouette, and Elon Musk says it is already being built. 2 days ago, when Tesla held its annual shareholder meeting, something significant happened that many people in the automotive industry probably didn't realize how important it was. While CEO Elon Musk said that the meeting was not the right place to make a new product announcement, he still decided to tease Tesla's next car. During the presentation, Musk confirmed that Tesla is currently working on two new vehicles that the automaker has yet to unveil. As the CEO discussed those, Tesla showed the silhouette of what is believed to be the next Tesla vehicle. Interestingly, Musk added that this vehicle is not being designed, but is being built. It's not exactly clear what he meant by that. Typically, the CEO uses this language for production, but it could mean the company is kind of quote-unquote building a prototype, a single version. Either way, the image is a render and not an absolute obscure picture. Tesla has been expecting to bring to market a small electric hatchback, often referred to as the $25,000 Tesla, or sometimes Tesla Model 2. We're also expecting Tesla to bring to market sometimes an electric passenger van. Recently, what appears to be a Tesla prototype built on a Mazda was spotted being tested in China, where Tesla said it would be designing and build its next vehicle. At the event 2 days ago, Musk added that Tesla is currently working on two new vehicles that it has yet to unveil, including this one teased at the Tesla event. The company estimates that those two vehicles will sell at a volume of about 5 million units per year. Imagine. The two vehicles are expected to be this cheaper and smaller hatchback and what Musk has been calling its robotaxi, a vehicle specifically designed for self-driving and for a taxi service. Tesla has previously talked about producing a cheaper model at Gigafactory Shanghai in China and exporting the vehicle globally. Now that Elon Musk has announced two unannounced vehicles with no details, let's discuss those vehicles and what they bring to the automotive market, friends. Let's start with unannounced features and then comment on the unannounced price, which I think is too high or too low or perhaps just right. But whatever it is, Tesla will change it with no notice. What do you think, friends, about those two new vehicles and about this new vehicle? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Tesla CEO Elon Musk just gave a very good update about Cybertruck's production timeline, putting the production estimate much lower than many people in the industry anticipated. So if you have Cybertruck coming, you have a reservation, please look forward to it. It may come earlier and sooner than you think. Despite the design of the electric pickup truck being polarizing, everything pointed to the Cybertruck having a robust demand. A tally showed that the Cybertruck had received over 1.5 million reservations. To be fair, those reservations only required a $100 refundable deposit, so it is not the strongest show of interest, but it is still an impressive number of reservations of people interested in Cybertruck. Many Tesla fans and analysts believe that the automaker could produce Cybertruck at the same rate as some 1 million unit pickup program in the United States, like the Ford F-150. However, CEO of Tesla Elon Musk has now managed expectations down. During a presentation at Tesla annual shareholder meeting yesterday, Musk reiterated Tesla's goal to bring Cybertruck to production later this year and volume production next year. This has been the timeline since earlier this year. The presentation was followed by a Q&A during which a Tesla shareholder asked Musk about Tesla's planned peak production capacity for Cybertruck at Gigafactory Texas. Here's what Elon Musk said. The CEO answered and said, there will be a S-curve production. So it will be slow at first and then ramping up. I guess we will see what the demand is, but we're likely to make 250,000 Cybertrucks a year, maybe more. It depends what the demand is like. He later added that he believed it will be between 250,000 and 500,000 units a year. The CEO also said it will be hard to make the Cybertruck affordable. This is an interesting comment. My biggest takeaway is that we should brace ourselves for an update on Cybertruck pricing, as many people thought in the industry before. We already knew that the $40,000 to $80,000 options for Cybertruck originally announced are now unrealistic following inflation, But I think those who were expecting a modest increase will now have to adjust their expectations. Now, obviously, the more expensive versions will come first, so I think we will not see a Cybertruck cheaper than likely $70,000 until 2025. If you were looking for a base version for less than $50,000, I don't think that will happen. As for cheaper than $60,000, probably not unit 2020, not until 2026. However, building electric vehicles, the prices are coming down, so we should see Tesla learning ways to build cars much less expensive, the cost will be coming down, and hopefully over the time car prices will come down just like television prices. But until now they have been going up, except some variations. So what do you think about the Cybertrucks coming sooner in the production? Let me know, friends, your thoughts in the comment section below. And what price do you expect to pay for Cybertruck, and how much are you willing to pay? So let's have a nice discussion in the comment section below about the pricing of the Cybertruck as it's imminent. And please subscribe to this channel, because I assume very soon Tesla will announce the Cybertruck pricing as it starts coming off the assembly line, and I will report that as soon as possible, keeping our finger on the pulse of this news.